Well, Chetan, it's really nice to see you again. I trust you had a good break over the New Year break.
Nice to see you and a Happy New Year. Hope you had a good break with your family.
I did. Thank you very much. So, Chetan, we were just talking about how things changed through the pandemic. And one of the points you were making was, as you talked to folk, a lot of businesses looked to simplify their legal footprint for a variety of reasons. Very interesting topic. What are you seeing as those key trigger points in people's minds?
That's a excellent, I would say that's the biggest trending aspect that we are seeing in the, you know, in the tax world. Is COVID-19 obviously has put focus on cost reduction. It goes without saying. Unfortunately, that has resulted in headcount reductions in many tax departments. And with cost reduction, you know, you have to manage, still manage your compliance, your risks, and all those things. And so cost reduction is definitely the biggest trigger point in companies reevaluating their tax structures or their legal structures as well, to making sure that they have an efficient structure that is manageable with the resources that companies have. The other trigger point we are seeing, or we have been seeing, is really tax reform, both in the U.S. as well as globally as well. And obviously with the tax TCJA, a lot of the structures that companies had in place pre-reform are not efficient anymore. And so multinationals have been proactively looking at rationalizing their tax structures to fit in today's tax environment. So those are kind of two biggest drivers we are seeing. One of the interesting trends we are seeing is a lot of companies, whenever they do acquisitions, there are so many multinationals that are doing, or we call it serial acquirers, they have acquired a lot of companies and have not really had time, because of resource constraint and because of so many acquisitions they've been doing, have not had time to really rationalize their structures post-acquisitions. And so we're seeing a lot of activity with multinationals who are evaluating their structures, their legacy acquisition structures, and rationalizing their legal entity structures as well. Again, a huge cost savings and efficiencies can be achieved. And so I do expect this trend to continue as we come out on the other side of the pandemic, as this definitely results in a lot of efficiencies, not only resource efficiencies, but also just keeps your structure efficient and agile.
So fascinating. So it's a mixture of what happened in the pandemic, just taking a look back at things, and then for those serial acquirers, almost like catching their breath and
absolutely
doing the things they wanted to do. And Chetan, are there other efficiencies that businesses are looking to capture as well?
Sure, absolutely. So clearly, you know, so we did, KPMG, we did a survey of tax departments on these type of projects. And what we have found is on a typical, what we call a legal entity rationalization project, it can bring a company potentially like about $35,000 to $50,000 of cost savings per legal entity that is eliminated, which is a significant amount. If you multiply that times 50 or 100, you know what annual cost savings you're going to get. But besides that cost savings, there are a lot of other kind of key efficiencies that I would like to address here. The first one is it does improve your governance. The smaller the number of entities, the better your governance generally is, because you have lesser number of entities to manage. The other part is when you have a rationalized legal entity structure, you are able to manage risk better in terms of your ability to effectively monitor and analyze current and future legal structure as well. And then last but not least, I mean, this is obviously now year-end time for folks here in the US. If you have a rationalized legal entity structure, it definitely helps you in your accounting process as well. Accounting departments also would love to have a rationalized legal entity structure. And it not only helps the accounting department, also the tax department, when it comes to doing provisions and managing the risks associated with provisions as well. So again, there are a lot of efficiencies that can be achieved, not beyond just the cost savings, which is obviously pretty material if you think about 35 to 50,000 a legal entity you eliminate.
And that's really interesting, Chetan, because I'm sure everyone thinks about the headline, what am I going to save out of this? But those qualitative things like governance and risk management, those are very valuable efficiencies to gain from such a process.
Absolutely.
Well, it's no wonder that you're super busy on this topic, Chetan. There's lots of opportunity there in terms of thinking about efficiencies that people can gain out of this that go beyond just the pure dollars and cents. Absolutely. Thank you very much for your time and talking to me about it.
Thanks, Rodney.